Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
Allah, Allah, you are my Lord. I bow to you, Allah, Allah, you are my Lord. I bow to you, Allah, 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 you are my Lord. I bow to you, Allah, 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 you are my Lord. I bow to you.
আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়া রাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়া বারাকাতুহু আলহামদুলিল্লাহি রাব্বিল আলামিন ওয়া সাল্লাল্লাহু ওয়া সাল্লাম ওয়া বারাকা আলা আবদিহি ওয়া রাসূলিহি নাবিনা মুহাম্মদ ওয়া আলা আলিহি ওয়া সাহবিহি আজমাইন আম্মা বা'দ আহলান ওয়া সাহলান ওয়া মারহাবান বিকুম I welcome my dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam to the final episode of our series A to Z of Janazah and Inheritance. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we've been discussing the matters related to Janazah, related to parting this world and going on to the hereafter. We discussed the masail related to Salatul Janazah, its manner and its method. We discussed the issue of the ghusl, how to perform the ghusl over the deceased. We learned that the kafan for the male is 3 pieces of material fabric. As for the female, then 5 pieces. Why? Because she requires a higher level of sitr, a higher level of covering. Walhamdulillah. Our final words in this world, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us that tawfiq to say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, we also do not forget that this kafan, that's the only thing of this world which we will take to the hereafter. وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا Do not forget your share of this dunya. What is it? It is the kafan, no doubt about that matter. We won't take our Mercedes-Benz. We won't take our palaces. We will not take all of those iPods and the iPads. Brothers and sisters, your gold and your shares will remain here. They will go to the heirs. But you will begin this journey and your currency is only أَعْمَالْ الصَّالِحَةِ Your good deeds. How did you live your life? How did you spend your youth? Where did you earn your money? Where did you spend your money? What did you do with your time? Allah musta'an. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who are successful. Brothers and sisters, in our previous episode, we ended off on the letter S. We learned that S was for the soul. S was also for the shaheed, the martyr. We move on from there and we begin with the letter T. And T is for what? T is for transportation. What does transportation got to do with janazah and inheritance? Well, sometimes we find that a brother, he's American and he passes away in Australia. And his family is in America. And they request that the body be transported from Australia to America. This transportation of the body after death, is this something allowed? The answer is, inshallah, is that it is permissible if there is maslaha. It is permissible if there is benefit. What type of benefit? For example, a burial in a place which is blessed. For example, someone passes away in Jeddah and he had willed that he be buried in Medina al-Munawwara or Makkah al-Mukarramah. And he willed this. It's not something that we decide, but he wrote in his will, he wrote in his wasiyah, he told someone, please, when I die, bury me in Makkah al-Mukarramah. So that's a benefit. Or for example, the individual, his family is not there. Family is in a completely different country and he willed that he be transported and buried in his original home country. And another condition is that there is no great expense in transporting the body to the other country. But if, for example, it's going to cost a few thousand dollars, it's going to cost maybe £5,000, etc., that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money and thus it would not be allowed. But if, for example, it's not such a huge amount of money, or maybe, for example, if the airline says we will transport the body for free, then bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, if there is maslaha, if there is benefit, and if there's not going to be any decomposition upon the body, then it would be allowed bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So that's the letter T. Then we move on to the letter U. And U is for what? U is for the undertaker. U is for the one who is in charge of this whole funeral procedure. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, it is recommended that the Muslim goes to the undertaker. You go to the funeral service and you tell them and you ask them, you know, I'd like to learn how to perform the ghusl upon the deceased. In fact, when anyone passes away in the community, I'd love for you to phone me up and ask me to participate. For verily, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, that's a reminder. If you are there at the ghusl of your Muslim brother and you participate and you wash his body, you will leave after that with a reminder that no 2-hour, 3-hour, 10-hour lecture could even do. Subhanallah. That experience would be the greatest reminder for you. That you see the body, you lift up the hand. The man, mashallah, while he was alive, full of strength, you see his muscles, but cannot even lift up the hand. There's no ruh. The ruh has left the body. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, you look at that brother full of muscles, youngster, he's in his 20s, but the angel of death took away his life. You still have an opportunity. Your books are still open, so make the best of it, inshaAllah. So you for the undertaker, and get involved with them, volunteer your services with them, inshaAllah. Some countries, if an individual passes away, because of the fact that they have a limited amount of space, and thus finding a grave now after you die very difficult, for your family finding a grave for you very difficult. So what they recommend is, while you are still alive, you need to purchase some earth, you need to purchase a plot in the graveyard, which would be your grave once you die. Imagine that, subhanAllah. You go and you buy your grave while you're still alive. That's the reality of life. You purchase your grave now, you can even visit it on a Thursday, on a Friday, on a Sunday, wherever you're passing by, look there. That's your final resting place. You're living in your house now temporarily, and you're going to come here, and that's your end. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, if only but we understood the reality of life, subhanAllah, then we would laugh less, and we would cry more. Allahu musta'an. V, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, is for what? V is for very sad. No doubt, the passing away of an individual in your family, passing away of your spouse, passing away of your father or your beloved mother, subhanAllah. It is a very, very sad event. It's a very, very sad matter. And that's why we recommend the people to come by and they should offer their condolences to you. They should try to support you. They should try to be a pillar of support for you. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. When Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala passed away, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are too preoccupied with this loss. So you people make some food and take to the home of Ja'far radiallahu anhu. They don't have the time to prepare food. You make something and give to them. How sad it is that the realities have changed. Today, when someone passes away, the first bother on the shoulder of the family is what? We need to prepare some food because people are going to come and what are they going to eat? Look at how we've changed the realities. The time of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people would prepare food for the family of the deceased so that they don't have to worry about food. Today, the first thing, someone's passed away, oh, inshallah, we'll go there to the house and at least we'll have lunch there. At least we'll have dinner there. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. In fact, the Sahaba would regard the preparation of food and this large gathering of people and everyone eating, it's like merrymaking. They would regard this as like that which was not permissible, that which was haram. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, no doubt, V. This is a very sad occasion. The passing away of a relative. The passing away of a son, of a daughter. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he buried his son Qasim, and then Abdullah, and then his daughters also passed away. Zainab, Ruqayya, Kulthum, they all passed away. His son Ibrahim, the one who lived up to the age of about 17 months, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to go there to the edge of town where Ibrahim was. And then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would hold him, would hug him. And he also passed away. Imagine burying one kid after the other. أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءَ ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلُ فَالْأَمْثَلُ. The people who go through the greatest trials and tribulations are the Anbiya. And then the people closest and closest to them. Ya ikhwan wal akhawan. When you lose a relative, remember the losses that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went through. Imagine 6 of his 7 children pass away in his lifetime. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. To Allah we belong and to Him we return. The letter W, brothers and sisters. W for a wasiyyah. What is a wasiyyah? Wasiyyah is this 1/3 of your estate that you are allowed to do with it as you wish, with two conditions. Number one, you're allowed to give it to a charity, a masjid. Give it to your neighbor, Muslim, non-Muslim, irrelevant. You can give to them all, walhamdulillah. You can give to the RSPCA, look after animals, whatever it might be. You can make this wasiyah for a good cause, inshallah, but it must be a non-heir. You cannot make a wasiyah, you cannot stipulate anything specific for an heir. Heir is the one who is going to inherit from you by default. So the wasiyah is only for a non-heir. And number two, it is only up to 1/3 of your estate. It cannot be more than 1/3. In fact, if someone made a wasiyah for more than 1/3, or he made a wasiyah for an heir, this is haram, number one. Number two, then it is up to the heirs if they want to allow it or they do not want to allow it. If the heirs say, no problem, our father wanted to give all of the money to the youngest kid, and we are happy with that. We are happy with that. We have enough, and let him take everything. Then it would be allowed. So it would be pending the permission of the heirs. If the heirs say, for example, our father made a wasiyah to the masjid, all of his wealth should go to the masjid. Mashallah, we are quite rich, we have enough. And although what the father did was wrong, he was not supposed to go beyond 1/3, but we allow it, we fine with it, we okay with it, we will not inherit from him, give it all to the masjid. If they okay, mashallah, tabarakallah, then it's allowed. But otherwise, the wasiyah has two rules attached to it. It cannot be more than 1/3. And number two, it must be made for an outsider, for a non-heir, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, remember and remember well that if a person has a lot of wealth, then it's recommended for him to make this wasiyah. But if a person has a little bit of money, then it's better that his money goes to his heirs, that they benefit from it, that his family benefit, and they don't have to ask of the people. That would be better, inshallah. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, that was the letter W, and W was for the wasiyah, walhamdulillah. Also, there is a wasiyah of advice, monetary wasiyah, and also wasiyah of advice. So you gather your kids, you gather your wife, your parents, and you tell them that my wasiyah is that you people help out a certain individual, that you people look after your salah, that you make from amongst your kids at least one a hafizul Quran, that at least one is student of knowledge. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, you speak to your kids, you speak to the people that you're going to leave behind, and you give them some advice. That's your parting advice. And that's the advice, the wasiyah of advice. So you have wasiyah of money and wasiyah of advice. Walhamdulillah. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we take a short break. When we return, we continue. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Muhammad, peace
pearls of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, reported Allah's messenger, may peace be upon him, as saying, verily, Allah likes three things for you, and he disapproves three things for you. He is pleased with you, that you worship him, and associate not anything with him, that you hold fast the rope of Allah, and be not scattered, and he disapproves for you irrelevant talk, persistent questioning, and the wasting of wealth. Sahih Muslim, Volume 3, Book of Judicial Decisions, Hadith number 4255.
If I were to ask you about the life of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the incidents that occurred before his prophethood and in Mecca and in Medina, about the names of his loved ones and his wives and his children, how much would we be able to know? How many incidents have we memorized? Brothers and sisters, isn't it more important that we study the seerah of the most important human being who ever walked the face of this earth? Join me, your host Yasir Qadhi, as we discuss the most important biography of the most illustrious human being that ever lived, the seerah of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Join Yasir Qadhi in Seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, next on Peace TV.
to you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We continue, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, W is also for a will. Do you have to have a will? The answer is that if you have debts and you owe people money and people owe you money, then you need to have a will because you need to stipulate this. Otherwise, people will not know who you owe. They might not pay it. And the people who you owe the money to might not come forward. And this will be a debt on your head. And that will be a problem in the hereafter. Also, if people owe you money, then technically your family needs to get this money. And so they inherit it as part of their inheritance. But what is the realm of the will? In my will, do I say I want to give to my uncle and give to my cousin and I want to give to this son and give to that son and this daughter? No. Whether you have a will or you don't have a will, your inheritance will go the route of the noble Quran. It will be distributed as per the noble Quran. So your will can help you in stipulating who owes you money, who you owe money to. It can help you with your wasiyah. So you can stipulate, I'm distributing, I'm giving one third to so and so. Your will can help you that if you owe kafara, if you owe debts to Allah, you owe money to the municipality, all of this you stipulate. But as for the last portion, which is the heirs, you cannot stipulate anything with regards to the heirs. If you do, it's still null and void. Why? Because the inheritance will go the route of the noble Quran. It will be distributed as per Allah's laws of succession. Walhamdulillah. W also for the widow, brothers and sisters. The widow, this female, that her husband's now passed away. She's in the iddah for 4 months and 10 days. After this, she can get married to whomsoever she wants, walhamdulillah. We do not have that idea and that practice that the sister's 17 years old, her husband's died. From 17 until the day that she dies, she's not allowed to get married out of respect for their husband. No, look at the Sahaba. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he married many, many females after their husbands had passed away. Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anha, Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, and many others. Khadija, his first wife, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. That everyone needs a partner, everyone needs a companion. And thus, the husband's passed away, and after the iddah, she's allowed to get married, insha'Allah. In fact, in the noble Quran, Allah talks about the mas'ala. What mas'ala? The mas'ala of that if the husband's passed away and she's in her iddah, it is allowed for someone to express interest to her, that they want to get married to her, but not explicitly, implicitly give an indication of your interest, that's allowed. Or you just mention, you know, when Sister Sumayya's iddah is over, you know, let me know. I know some good brothers who are interested in getting married. That would be allowed, subhanAllah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. That was W, W for the wasiyah, W for the will, and lastly, W for the widow. And many have invented certain rules and regulations with regards to the widow. They say she should only wear black. Others state that she should take an egg, crack the egg, throw the egg behind her back. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What is that? And some have said that the husband who's died, that from his grave, take some sand, mix it with water, and then give her to drink. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What might occur is that she might die and also join him. We're not supposed to be drinking sandy water. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. With regards to the will, as we said, if you owe people money, people owe you money, then you need to have it stipulated, written down. And that's how we understand those ahadith which talk about that you should not go to sleep except that you should have your will written down. That's if you owe people or people owe you money. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. We move on to the letter X. And X is for what? X is for exiting this world. Our exit from this realm. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, nobody knows when they will die. Nobody knows when the angel of death is going to visit them. Bilal radiallahu anhu would always be in a state of wudu. And one benefit from that is that when he passed away, insha'Allah, he would pass away in a state of purification. We know one of those companions, he fought in a battle and he was a martyr. But he was in a state of janaba because he had just consummated his marriage and quickly he had to go out and rush to battle. The angels came down and performed the ghusl over him. Ghasil al-malaika, he is called. The one who was washed by the malaika. Your exit from this world, Ya Akhil Kareem, Ya Ukhtil Kareema. When you are lying on that bed, it is recommended that you face towards the Qibla. The people around you should make your body face towards the Qibla. And it's recommended that those around you should be engaged in dua. The person, he is going through sakarat. The angel of death is coming. Do not scream, do not shout. Verily, the angels answer your du'as. Make du'a for this person who is going through this sakarat. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah. Remind the individual to say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. He's about to exit this realm. Remind him, but do not force the matter. Sometimes he's unable to even verbalize it. Sometimes he only indicates with his fingers. But you remind, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, it will happen on his tongue. Bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, he will think about it. The matter of Tawheed, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. Once the angel of death takes the ruh and the ruh exits the body, the eye follows it. And then what should we do? We should close the eyes. And if any of the limbs are raised, then put them all down. For verily, very soon, the body is going to stiffen up. Imagine, once the ruh leaves, then the body stiffens up. The ruh in reality is that life. Otherwise, this body, it's just a vessel for that ruh. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, that's the exit from this realm to the hereafter. The journey to the hereafter, the good angels, if you were good, angels of paradise come, they take your soul, put it in fragrant sheets and take it up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you were an evil soul, then the coarse angels, the rough, tough angels come, they drag this and they pull it, they yank it out of your body. And then they put it in smelling pieces of garments, cloths, and they take it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, that soul which is good passes by the various heavens and they all say, enter, enter, enter from here. And if it is an evil soul, none of them would want that soul to enter and bypass its doors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us husnul khatima. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us jannatul firdaus. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a grave which is a pit, or rather a grave which is a pit, or rather a palace from amongst the palaces of paradise. May Allah grant us that grave which is a palace from amongst the palaces of paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us jannatul firdaus. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, why? Why is for what? Why is for you? And you need to stock take. I need to stock take with regards to our actions. حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا وزنوا أنفسكم قبل أن توزنوا. And pray before you are prayed over. Weigh yourself, hold yourself accountable in this world before you are held accountable in the hereafter. Brothers and sisters, it's a journey that we're all going to go on. Myself, yourself, and everyone else. Are we going to be successful in that journey? Do we have the answers for the grave? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. Are we those who say the kalima of Tawheed upon our tongues and we commit shirk in the afternoon? Are we those who say that we're supposed to be truthful and we are the ones that people do not trust? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. Lima taquloon ma la taf'aloon. Kabura maqtan inda Allahi an taqulu ma la taf'aloon. Why do you say that which you do not do? And it's a major sin with Allah that you say and you do not do. He talks about staying away from zina, but he is the first one in it. He talks about the evils of lying, and he is the first one to do it. He talks about lowering the gaze, but he is the one who never ever lowers his gaze. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For verily he is at-tawab, he is al-ghaffar, he is al-rahim, he is al-rahman. And he is the one who wipes away all sins. At-tawbah yajubbu ma qablaha. Tawbah wipes away everything before it, insha'Allah. So why? Why is for you? Why is for myself also that we need to take stock with regards to our a'mal, with regards to our actions? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah. We want that Quran to come in our graves and intercede on our behalf. We want Salah to come and intercede on our behalf. We want all of these actions to come and intercede on our behalf. We do not want lies to come there and say, I was his friend. We do not want zina to come there and say, he was part and parcel with me. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, Zed. And Zed is for zzz. Zed is for a steep. When we go to steep every evening, what do we say? Bismika Allahumma ahya wa amut. That in the name of Allah, I die and I live. For verily, you're going to steep is a small debt. You're going to sleep every night, subhanAllah. It is the minor debt. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, one day your eyes are going to close. And it will not open again until you are resurrected on Yawmul Qiyamah. Many a person right now, on this earth, their eyes closed, but their eyes did not open again. Allah blessed you, alhamdulillah. Now that's why when we wake up in the morning, what do we say? Alhamdulillahi alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Praise be to Allah who gave me life after causing me to die. We praise Allah because we still have a chance. But there's many others who close their eyes and their eyes did not open again. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, the matter of death, it is not a light matter. It is a grave matter. And no doubt, that's where we will all go. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, past and present. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala record our deeds in the scales of good deeds. May Allah grant us ikhlas in whatever we do. Hayyakumullah, Jazakumullahu khairan. Your brother in Islam, Bilal Ismail. With this, we end the A to Z of janazah and inheritance. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah, Allah, you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, 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 you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, 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 you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you are my Lord, I bow to you. Allah, Allah, you
The more you hear about it, the more you desire to prepare for it. Life after death. Journey of the soul. The day of resurrection. The torment of the hellfire. The reward of paradise. Stay tuned for a life-changing, heart-softening, spiritually uplifting series about the hereafter exclusively on Peace TV.
Know the vivid descriptions of paradise and hellfire from the Quran and authentic ahadith, and acquire life-changing habits to be successful in the hereafter. Every Tuesday at 6 p.m. and repeat telecast at 5:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
What would you recommend?
Peace TV presents...
What would you have to say about...
Learning the wise way.
What would you recommend us to take as career?
After we pass our school, so what exactly we should do?
What do you have to say about pursuing two fields together?
Ideas brilliant. Strategy sustained.
The best profession is a professional person who invites people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Avail the opportunity with Dr. Zakir.
Depending upon what is your interest. But the main aim should be to spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To implement the convincing Islamic cum educational formula to excel in your career. Watch Career Guidance every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.